Moving itself isn't my favorite thing to do. I don't think it's anybody's favorite thing to do.
What do studies say is as stressful as having a baby or getting married? You got it, moving.
35 million Americans do it every year, and I will guarantee you 35 million Americans hate it. But there are some simple steps you can take that are going to reduce both your stress and your expense.
Step one, start early, be flexible. Think off season and off peak.
Want to try to move in the middle of the week, at the middle of the month, and when the kids are in school.
Step two, ruthlessly rid yourself of everything you don't need. Don't pay more to move something than it's worth. Now are you ready to hire that mover? Not yet. First, go to protectyourmove.gov and read about what to expect, including red flags for moving fraud. After you do that, now you're ready for estimates, three at least. Pit movers against each other to get the best deal, but read all the fine print. Make sure you're comparing apples to apples.
Another way you can save is getting free boxes, but make sure they're quality. You can check places like Craigslist and FreeCycle, but you can also buy inexpensive boxes at places like Home Depot that might do the job.
And the single best way to save? Do everything you can yourself.
Label your boxes, pack everything into a box, stack things near exits. That makes it come out in and out of the house quicker.
Finally, keep good records. You never know when you're going to need to file a claim, and you might be able to take a tax deduction. Bottom line, moving is a nightmare. Don't make it harder on yourself. Shop early, know what you're doing, read the fine print, and roll up those sleeves. Now what you need is more information. It's waiting for you at MoneyTalksNews.com. Just do a search for moving. For Money Talks News, I'm Stacy Johnson.